This entire situation where Krishna was chosen for these purposes, such as mediation and compromise, the fact that Krishna was chosen for this purpose, as well as for asking the Kauravas to return half of the kingdom back to the Pandavas, all these situations are very unique and special and sacrosanct, done on a principle, and it is very special. So Krishna, before embarking on this journey towards the Kauravas, he asks the opinions of all the Pandavas, including Draupadi. So Dharmaraya at last makes this decision of choosing Krishna to be the right person to do this job, and Krishna says okay and accepts this proposal to go. But Krishna will have a doubt in his mind if this plan is going to be fruitful or not. But he thinks that mediation is the last resort and this path must be tried no matter what. So Pandavas say to Krishna, "You are our well-wisher and the most important person. So we will send you and please do the mediation on our behalf." And then Kumaravyasa has a poetry written for this purpose when Krishna arrives for mediation. And in Kumaravyasa Bharata, Krishna is the main protagonist and the most important person. Kumaravyasa calls Mahabharata as Krishna's story itself. Therefore, Krishna itself is the main character as per Kumaravyasa Bharata. So Krishna is going to plead with Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana. So Krishna says, "Look, please return the kingdom back to the Pandavas. The Pandavas have gone through a difficult time. They spent 12 years in exile in the forest." The Kaurava at last says he will not return the kingdom back. Drona, Bhishma, all of them had a doubt whether or not the kingdom will be returned. Dushyasana, Karna, Shakuni were to be brought together in the mediation too. Dhritarashtra is a good guy, but when they talk of Kaurava, he gets his head all messed up. So Krishna came to the mediation and makes it look so nice and says to Kaurava, "Look, nothing is permanent, Kaurava. Don't have so much love over this piece of earth. Just do not be so hard-hearted. Just return the half of the kingdom to the Pandavas and they deserve it." But the Kaurava does not accept the offer. He actually shames Krishna verbally. So he says, "You and Vidura, both of you are cowherders. You make a good pair, ha ha ha." He should not have raised the caste in his banter, but he did. The Kaurava could have argued as much as he wanted, but bringing up the caste differences was not the right thing to do. Why should the caste be brought up in the argument? There is a curse by itself by doing that. Krishna is defeated in this big assembly when the Kaurava speaks this way. Drona, Bhishma, all of them were present in the assembly. And then Krishna says to Kaurava, "Kaurava, this is not permanent. Why for a piece of land should we fight this much? Let us be happy among ourselves. Just return the half of the kingdom back to the Pandavas." But that does not happen. The Kaurava says, "Hey, look, Krishna, the way you are asking it is just like you are doing empty talk. It looks and feels like a drama, not a real thing. You are asking to return the kingdom in front of everybody. I think you really don't like to receive it anyway. You might be talking about compromise, but I think that is not on your mind. I think your mind says, go to war." Therefore, he tells everyone in the assembly not to believe Krishna. So Krishna is now confident Kaurava did not accept his proposal and that it will not happen. So children, you all know a needle. If you prick the earth, how much of the earth does that prick cover? Very little, isn't it? So the Kaurava says, "I will not even return that much area to you or the Pandavas." He speaks very roughly to Krishna. So Krishna always thought he was a very expert in doing this kind of negotiations, but now he has failed. And then there is Sama, Beda, Dana and Danda. So Beda means, for example, Karna is very important for Kaurava. So Beda means bringing difference between people. Now, Pandavas and Kauravas don't like each other, and now, if you bring the differences in the Kauravas themselves, so, this is the plan Krishna is thinking. It is called divide and rule method of thinking. Look at Krishna. Children, he is thinking in these lines. So, if siblings, that is brothers, are very loving, then bring a difference between them and then see the fun. So, say that your brother who gave you the orchard is all very barren and what he kept is very fertile. So the plan is to bring fight between the brothers and bring Karna on the side or on one party. So this is called Krishna Karna Samvada. Samvada means this. Say in your home sometimes your dad will ask your opinions like what color walls do you like, etc. Black color or green or white. Then you talk to each other. This is called Samvada. So one of them says white is good, the other says red is good because it's attractive. And then the other son says yellow is good because all homes have yellow walls. So doing a discussion of what is good is called Samvada. It's also called during a study or critical analysis. So Krishna says, okay, I'm going. But while leaving, he asks Karna to go with him. Karna is very surprised what Krishna does to him. So Karna will have the thinking that he is small in front of everybody and that he is kind of discriminated. So children, people must always have an inclusive mind of having everyone around, like brothers, uncles, relatives, sisters. But if they are not, they get cowardly. So Karna was a great warrior, but when someone asks him if he is a Kshatriya, then he says he is not a Kshatriya. So he is actually a Suta. His father was building a chariot. That was his job. He belonged to a daily and hourly wagers group of people. Krupa Shalya will always be asking him, what caste you belong to? Karna goes blank when he faces this situation. Now Kshatriyas can fight. So the Kaurava comes and intervenes and says, why are you all talking about caste? He says, is there a caste for people who are victorious? If you cut someone with a blade, everyone will bleed. It does not discriminate. It does not discriminate whichever caste the person belongs to. Everyone drinks the same water. Everybody sinks the same water. There is only one earth. So, where is the discrimination when we think about these things? So, this did not actually get into Karna's thinking or mind. So, Krishna takes Karna very close to him. So much so that he rubs his skin against Karna's, that close. Krishna himself has changed a little bit. In the beginning, he talked about how he shows only love. He says to Karna very lovingly, Karna, please come. Karna becomes very shy because whatever it is, Krishna is older and wiser than him, isn't it? Karna says, I am no one in front of you. Your respectful feet is saying I am an ordinary person compared to you, Krishna. Why are you calling me so close to you and sitting so close to me and wrapping your hands around my shoulders? He says, I am a small person. And I am no important person. There is not so much importance given to me at all. Therefore, I have no place to sit next to you. This is wrong. Children, you all think you all go to school. You all are one when you are in school. There is no question who is what caste. But why talk or discuss caste? If you think of that, the Kshatriyas themselves are on the bottom caste people. Because they are always fighting. They are always talking about war, fighting, beating up somebody or a sword, bow and arrow. But Krishna acts that way when he sees Karna. Karna says, how can we both be equal? Don't do that. I will be in great trouble. So my request is, don't let me sit next to you, he says.